missed all the signs. Am I crazy? Was I just blind? Yes, my darling, we're moving too fast. Jump the rails, oh, here comes the crash. Now I'm a train wreck, out of control. Don't know how you had it going.
Hey folks, Doug at the ranch, back again with another Landlord episode for you. This is number 5, I believe. Today we're doing some electrical and mechanical work. So today we're going to install what's called the field wiring. So if we look really close at the little legend down here in the corner, the field wiring is the dotted line. The dotted line consists of the low voltage side, which is from the thermostat down to the control board, and also the connections from our house supply, 120 volts, white, black, and ground that you see at the bottom of the schematic. The rest of this is all diagnostic stuff, which we don't have to get really involved in. As an HVAC technician, yes, I have to be able to read and decipher all this nonsense, but for the average Joe Blow, you don't have to. The primary reason I wanted to show you this is because Sean Velvet Hammer is quite interested in these high efficiency furnaces. So, Sean, this one's for you, buddy. We'll dedicate this one to you. So, getting back to the unit, basically it's the same as it was in the last video. The only thing that's changed is we've added the electrical connection there. We've come out with a plastic L. We're dropping down into some BX, which is vinyl clad, coming up to a disconnect right here. We need a disconnect so that if anybody services the unit, myself included, you need to be able to power it down. It is not allowed that you just run over to the panel and flip the breaker. So from there, we're going to terminate at the ceiling, and there's a lot of junk in the way, I apologize, but basically I'll zoom in and you can see the transition from the hard pipe conduit right there to a piece of Romex, which is that yellow cable, and that goes back to our 100 amp panel that services this apartment. Okay, and hang on 1 minute and I'll show you where we're at with ductwork placement. Okay, we're back. Just a quickie. This is a direct vent furnace, and what that means is the intake and exhaust, which is what you're looking at, it's 2-inch schedule 40 PVC straight plain cheap plumbing pipe is what it is, and we'll be back. Okay, this is the view in the basement below the new kitchen floor. If you've been following my videos, you know there's a brand new porcelain tile floor in the kitchen. Well, that's the drop for the 8x10 register, and that's going to come through the ceiling hole that you see there and turn the corner at 90 degrees and go through the old lath and plaster wall and break out on the other side, and I'll bring you right back and show you the other view. The light in here isn't the best, but there's your opposite that partition. And that's going to be our, we're going to run 6-inch through there, and that's going to run down the length of this run and actually terminate into this, what used to be a closet at one time. The lighting is terrible, I know, but yeah, we're going to remanufacture this a little bit. There is some ductwork in here now, which services the apartment above the apartment we're working on. So all that ductwork is going to remain, but we're going to replace the new line in the same area because this closet is no longer used. It's more of a junk storage place than anything. So we're going to work on that going forward. So thanks for watching.